Hello and welcome to the tutorial video of differential length, area and volume of all coordinate systems. This is the part of electromagnetic field theory. So we'll see the easiest way to understand the differential length, differential area, that means surface area, and differential volume. So we'll start with the coordinate systems, like differential lengths in all coordinate system. First of all, we'll study about the coordinate systems. Previously we know that we have three coordinate system: rectangular coordinate system, which have three coordinates x, y and z; cylindrical coordinate system, which have three coordinates rho, comma, phi and z; and a spherical coordinate system, again we have three, like r, theta and phi. So by understanding these all coordinates, we need to know what is the differential length of all these three coordinates. So starting with the first coordinate system, that is rectangular or Cartesian coordinate system. So this is the, we can see, a simplest way, or this is the a trick to understand, to know the what this all coordinate systems in and how we'll easily find out the their differential lengths. So I have tried to simplify it on the basis of their differential lengths. So I have mentioned over here the coordinates, all three coordinates, and their corresponding differential lengths. So what you have to recognize, what do you have to understand, is for rectangular coordinate system I have taken 1, 1, 1, that means x, y, z will becomes dx, dy and dz, because it has to be multiplied with 1, 1 and 1. So if you go to the cylindrical coordinate system, we see the multiplication factor is 1, rho and 1. So the first coordinate, rho becomes d rho in differential length, and d second phi becomes d phi, and multiplication factor is rho, so it becomes rho d phi. And the third factor, z, becomes dz, and multiplication factor is 1, so it becomes dz. Now we'll go to the third one, a spherical coordinate system. As we know that the spherical coordinate system have three coordinate, r, theta and phi. So the their multiplication factors are 1, r and r sin theta. The first r becomes dr and multiplication factor is 1, so it will be dr only. But the second one, d theta, becomes r d theta, because the multiplication factor is r. And the third one becomes r sin theta d phi, because the multiplication factor is r sin theta. So now the easiest way to recall it is 1, 1, 1, 1, rho, 1 and 1, r sin theta. This three you have to remember. That's the only way to understand this differential length. Even though if you'll have this three part, like 1, 1, 1, 1, rho, 1 and 1, r sin theta, you can easily find out the differential length, differential area and differential volume. Now we'll recall it all three for Cartesian coordinates or rectangular coordinates. Now differential length, as you know that we have x, y, z, so it becomes dx in the direction of ax, dy in the direction of ay, and dz in the direction of az. So differential length is nothing but a vector, so that's why it has all three directions. Now we'll go to the differential area. So this part is main area of concern, because here the most of the students get confused. So first, to understand this, I'll show you a small figure. Like if you have a area that is perpendicular in the direction of ax, so except this x, you have to take another two part. Like if you are taking the in the x directions, you have to consider, I mean exempting x, you have to take y and z. If you your area is perpendicular in the y directions, then you will exempt this y direction, you will take dz and dx. Similarly, if your area is perpendicular to the z directions, then you will accept this z direction, you will consider another two, dx and dy. So I have shown here, look at ds, differential area in the direction of ax, So here remove this x part, and take another two, that means dy and dz. So dy dz in the direction of x. If you are taking the direction of ay, that is if it is perpendicular to the direction of y, so then exempt y and take another two, that means dx and dz. If you are taking the z direction, then you take accept this z, you take dx and dy. But in the case of differential volume, you have all three, dx, dy and dz, because it is not a vector quantity, it is a scalar quantity. On to the next. Already I have explained this one, differential length, area and volume in cylindrical coordinate. So in cylindrical coordinate, so keep here that you just keep this one, 1 1 1 1 rho 1 and 1 r sine theta along with you always, so that you can easily recall it whenever you require. So as you know that we have differential length d rho, rho d phi and dz, so just put their direction, d rho in the direction of a rho, rho d phi in the direction of a phi, dz in the direction of a z. But when you are coming to the differential area, similar to the rectangular coordinate system, if you are taking a rho, that means this direction, so accept this one d rho, you consider this two, that means rho d phi dz in the direction of a rho. If you are taking the another direction like a phi direction, so this you have to accept, and you have to remove or exempt this part, phi part, and you take d rho and dz in the direction of a phi. If you are taking the z direction, because it is a perpendicular in the direction of z, so you accept z, you take all two, like d rho and rho d phi, d rho and rho d phi in the direction of az. But in the case of differential volume, again you will have all three, like d rho, rho d phi and dz. Similar to the Cartesian and cylindricals, we have one spherical coordinates also. So for spherical coordinates, again we have the differential length. As we know that these three coordinates are theta and phi, so we'll take this differential length in terms of dr in the direction of ar, r d theta in the direction of a theta, and r sine theta d phi in the direction of a phi. So when we are coming on the part differential area, here we have to again think, if you are taking in the ar direction, that means if the area is perpendicular to the ar, then accept r, we will take this two, r d theta, r sine theta d phi. If you are taking that a theta direction, that means accept this directions, you take this both dr and r sine theta, that means dr and r sine theta d phi in the direction of a theta. If you are taking this one, a phi direction, that means a phi, the area is perpendicular to the a phi, then you accept this one, you take dr and r d theta. So finally, if you are taking the differential volume, so you take all these three, that means dr, r d theta and r sin theta, so it becomes dr, r d theta and r sin theta d phi. So this is the all about differential length, differential area, differential volume in all three coordinate systems. So, and you have to keep it in your mind that always the dl and ds, that means differential length and differential volume surface, are the vector quantity, but differential volume is not a vector quantity, because if you are, it is either dot products of all these three, and it gives always a scalar. Okay, so that's it from this part. If you have any doubt, please ask me, you're most welcome, and I always require your feedback. And the most important part which you have to remember is this one, the coordinate and their differential length. So just this three lines, that 1 1 1 for rectangular coordinate system, 1 rho comma 1 for cylindrical coordinate system, 1 r sin theta for spherical coordinate system. Thank you.